So I hope you'll forgive me if I'm a little frustrated that some of us are choosing to ignore Donald Trump's gross incompetence while asking Kamala to dazzle us at every turn. I hope that you'll forgive me if I'm a little angry that we are indifferent to his erratic behavior, his obvious mental decline, his history as a convicted felon, a known slumlord, a predator found liable for sexual abuse, all of this while we pick apart Kamala's answers from interviews that he doesn't even have the courage to do, y'all. I am praying that those of us contemplating voting for Trump or not voting at all will snap out of whatever fog we are in. I am praying that we consider the decades of sacrifice and struggle by all of our ancestors, the folks who marched and sacrificed and shed their blood for us. We have to ask ourselves, is a vote for Trump or no vote at all the way we honor their lives? And if that's the case, well, that surely doesn't sound like freedom to me. I hope that you will forgive me if I am worried that we will blow this opportunity to finally turn the page on the ugliness once and for all. Because believe me, if Donald Trump is president again, at some point or another, that ugliness will touch all of our lives. There are still folks wringing their hands, crossing their arms, tuning out, saying they plan to sit this election out to prove a point. Well, let me tell you who isn't tuning out. Many of the folks who served closest to Trump and saw the danger firsthand. His former vice president, almost half of his former cabinet members, the growing list of four-star generals and Republican governors and senators and former House members, all of whom are not publicly supporting his candidacy the second time around. Y'all hear what I said? They are saying no, thank you. And finally, y'all, who could possibly think that this man would care more about our men and boys more than Kamala Harris? And while we're at it, I want to think about who do you think possibly would care more about our reproductive health? Look, a woman's body is complicated business, y'all. So I am asking y'all from the core of my being to take our lives seriously. Please. So please, please do not hand our fates over to the likes of Trump, who knows nothing about us, who has shown deep contempt for us. Because a vote for him is a vote against us. Against our health, against our worth. Let me warn you, your rage does not exist in a vacuum. If we don't get this election right, your wife, your daughter, your mother, we as women will become collateral damage to your rage. So, fellas, before you cast your votes, ask yourselves, what side of history do you want to be on? And we are more than just baby-making vessels. And if you are a woman who lives in a household of men that don't listen to you or value your opinion, just remember that your vote is a private matter. Regardless of the political views of your partner, you get to choose. You get to use your judgment and cast your vote for yourself and the women in your life. Remember, women, standing up for what is best for us can make the difference in this election.